Anders Strom says, I have been on testosterone replacement therapy for 5 years and stopped 5 years ago. My total T is very low, between 100 in the AM and 45 in the PM. I have been off. Doesn't put the units. That's very low if it's what I'm familiar with.
US or not.
I have been off from 2 years now. Anders, if you're replying, could you put the units in for the testosterone? I've been off for 2 years now. How long should I wait it out? His results are nanograms per milliliter, apparently, because his free T is 1.4 nanograms per milliliter.
Good gracious.
I've been off for 2 years now. How long should I wait it out before giving up and going back? I feel good, but there are risks with prolonged low T. My free T is 1.4 nanograms per milliliter and 55, but have good muscle strength and mass, and I'm not putting on weight, but libido is pretty low.
Well, first of all, I would want to find out why you aren't making testosterone. So I would definitely have your practitioner run an LH on you, luteinizing hormone.
The total is nanograms per deciliter.
Okay. So men have luteinizing hormone just like women do. It comes from the brain, and it's what stimulates the testes to make testosterone. So Anders, if you have low LH, then I know it's a brain problem, not necessarily a testicular problem. And if your LH is normal, if it's in the range.
He says LH and FSH are good.
How about prolactin?
How about prolactin, Anders?
Thyroid?
Thyroid?
Heavy metals? Like lead? Lead concentrates in the testicular tissue?
I'll just throw in my my stuff here. So,
go for it.
So MK4 is a form of vitamin K2 that in the testicles it increases the gene expression involved in testosterone synthesis. And osteocalcin is a vitamin K2 dependent protein that is kept in the bone and released during bone resorption that stimulates testosterone production in the male testes. So you can actually measure undercarboxylated osteocalcin in the blood through either Quest or I think it's Genova that has the undercarboxylated version. But that would be worthwhile. And yeah. I'd put vitamin K in one of the list of things that you could look into.
For sure.
He says prolactin is good. Thyroid is good.
Definitely check vitamin K.
Vitamin K, heavy metals, anything else on the list?
Well, I was going to say, his question was, how long do I wait till I throw in the towel? Oh, but
yeah.
And the other thing, you know, how old is he? Does he have a history
55.
Oh, 55. I missed that part. Okay. Okay. I mean, if you just got your testosterone checked and...
He says his vitamin K is good.
Well, dang. Trying to think of other big reasons for suppressed testosterone.
Anders, how is your sleep?
And insulin.
And how is your insulin? Sleeps like a rock.
Of course he does. Why not?
And he feels good. He says he feels good.
Has he tried Clomid or HCGs? Has he tried any of those to try to get his own testicular production up there?
Anders, have you tried any of them? Dangerous stuff, he says.
Well, but it would give you answers. That would give you answers. If you did a trial of Clomid and your own testosterone production did not go up, then you know you've got, right? Your Leydig cells are not making testosterone. But if you do Clomid and your testosterone does go up, it's a lot more encouraging that you have the ability still.
Mm.
So you don't have to do it long-term. We just use it as a trial to see if your Leydig cells are actually able to produce testosterone anymore. So you can use it short-term for diagnostic purposes.
That makes sense to me. He says MK2866 works some. I'm not sure what that is. Do you know?
I don't know what that is either.
Let me Google it quick.
It's Wikipedia that.
Osterine. It's a selective androgen receptor modulator.
Oh, right, right, right. Okay. Okay. And you said that works somewhat?
Yeah. I mean, that doesn't really answer anything about why the testosterone is low, right? So his testosterone's low and he compensates for that by using a selective androgen receptor agonist.
Right.
It's just replacing, that's not doing anything to the testosterone or providing any answers to why it's low. Okay, so we got triclomid and see if it goes up. Is a test worth doing as a short-term trial to gain answers?
And if it does, it's more encouraging. It means that your cells are still like, have it in them.
You know, I kind of wonder, Andrew says, had you done testosterone tests before that were higher? Or do we have any reason to think that they've always been this low? I mean, I am a little bit curious if, I know there's health risks of having low testosterone, but, mm-hmm. But there's gotta be normal variations that, I don't know, it would be interesting to know if this was age related or if he had low baseline. So it'd be 340 before he went on TRT.
I'm assuming that's his total, of course.
Yeah, well, it must be, but but now his total is 45. Is that right?
Oh, I thought it was 145.
No. It's 100 in the morning and 45 in the night.
Yikes.
So he had a lot higher before he went on TRT. So it looks like he's got long-term suppression or, you know, that was 10 years ago. So, or he's 55 now, he was 45 before. So that might be significant too.
Yeah. Any history of steroid use?
And have you used other steroids?
Opioids.
Opioids.
I'm seeing that more and more.
No, both.
Okay.
Do you have any thoughts on his actual question, which is how long should he wait it out before giving up and going back?
Oh, don't wait. I would go get a Clomid challenge now. And because then I would see if the testicular cells are functioning or not.
Yeah. I mean, if the question is how long should he wait, waiting is probably not going to give you any more answers than it was giving you for the last 5 years.
Right.
And waiting probably isn't going to raise your testosterone. I mean, if you have one measurement that it's 100 in the morning and 45 in the night, you don't really know if it's increasing. Like maybe 6 months ago it was 50. So yeah. If you wanted to wait, what I would do is do some follow-up testing to see if it's actually changing over time. But I mean, if it's been flattened out for 5 years, I don't think it's going anywhere. But if it's been going up 10 nanograms per nanograms per deciliter every 3 months for the last 5 years, then you probably could wait it out. But without knowing that, there's no data indicating that waiting is a good strategy here, it sounds like. So
I would agree.
All right. Thank you, Anders.